Well, the sun is well and truly up, so I thought I'd take this opportunity to do a little bit of a test on some filters that I've been sent. Now, I don't do a huge amount of product reviews, mainly because a lot of the stuff that I get asked to look at is not stuff I would use, and I don't see the point in that. K&F, whose products I quite like, I still love their tripod, I'm still using it, it's a fabulous bit of kit, asked me if I'd have a look at their magnetic filter kit. So I said, yeah, go on then, I'll have a go at that. What I'd forgotten was that it doesn't come with a grad filter. There's a drawback to everything. And on a day like today, you really need a grad filter to bring the sky down. Yes, I know I could bracket, but I really don't want to bracket. So I've been looking around Camas Bay for something I could shoot without having to use a grad filter. So I've come up back up to the steps that I was at this morning, and I decided actually there wasn't anything here that I could shoot. And down in the water, you may be able to see, there's a marker post, which is a little bit drunk. It's got a fascinating top to it. I can't make up my mind if it's just rubbish that's attached itself to it, or if it's meant to be something. But I've framed up so that I can... Oh, I'm getting attacked by flies and wasps and bees. I can exclude the sky. Now, in this kit is a circular polariser. Fabulous. An ND1000. Why don't you call it a 10-stop? It's the one bugbear I have with K&F. Why don't you just call it a 10-stop filter? ND1000. ND1000? I've got my glasses on. Yeah, ND1000. Baffles me. It's a 10-stop. Just call it that. It also has a UV filter. Now, the only time I've ever used a UV filter is when I've been shooting motocross to try and protect the front element from the mud and the stones that get flung up. So the UV filter's not even going to make it out of its pouch. So give me a second and I'll open the box up and show you what's in there. Well, it comes in a little cardboard box, and then it comes in this quite useful, pleasant little pouch. Now, I'm trying to do this with just one person, so it gets a little bit difficult to show you what's what. That's quite a neat little pouch, and it's got a little strap on the back so that you can put it over your belt loop, or you can hang it on a carabiner or something like that. And then we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the one. Now, that they all come in these little plastic bags, which are going to last about 30 seconds with me. Let's just take that off. Now, that is the magnetic holder. There's a, you ought to see it, yeah, there's a screw thread there that just screws into the front of your lens. This is a 77mm kit. So we'll put that on. What's that? That looks like it might be the UV. Yeah, so that's the UV, so we don't want that. They say, unless you're shooting sports where you're going to be running the risk of stones, etc., flying up, then I don't think you really need to bother with that. That is circular polariser. Oh, excellent. I don't know how much I like circular polarisers, so we'll... Oh, yeah. If you can hear that. It just clips in. It's quite neat, that. That's a lot less fiddling than flipping leaf filter system. That circular polariser and me have fallen out on so many occasions. That's really good. And then it spins whilst it's in there. Not quite as easy as I first thought. It does need a little bit of a jiggle to make sure the right bits are in. So that's that. So I will attach that to the front of the lens, and then, let me just get that out of the way a second. We'll put it on the floor, and then that one is, or should be, yeah, the 10-stop. Let's put that in there. As I say, the plastic bags are all very well, but they're not last with me. So I've got polarizer, oops, daisy, and then the 10-stop. Give me a second to grab the camera. Right. So I've got the 17-55 lens on. I've taken my Lee filter ring off, and that theoretically, yep, that just screws in the front. And I'm being careful not to over tighten it, because if I can't get that off, I can't put my Lee filter holder on. That is the circular polariser. You'll be able to make that out, and that should, yep, just clip on, and then it spins, most importantly, without affecting the filter ring. So I'm going to pop that on the camera and see if I can see what happens. The plan is, oh, hang on a second. The plan is to do a shot with the K&F Concept filter and then do the same shot with the leaf filter system. I'm going to leave all the settings exactly the same. I'm thinking we're going to be at around about f13, f14, because it's ridiculously bright, so even with a 10 stop, I'm not going to get a hugely long exposure. I'm going to set the white balance to 10,000 kelvins and then see what the difference is, see what sort of colour cast we get, if any. And we'll see. I say, it's not really a startling image, but it's the only thing I've come across I could maybe do something with. I had got in mind to do some waterfalls, but it's been that dry just lately. I think I'm going to have enough water there. So give me a second to get the camera in situ. As you can see, I'm perched precariously on a cliff. Don't really want anything to go walkabouts. Right, I focused on the pole. The filter ring and the circular polariser are already on the front. So I'm just going to spin the polariser and see what, if any, effect it makes. Oh yes, now I'd like it dark. Okay, it's not a huge difference. The sun's over there, it's maybe not quite the right angle to use a polariser. We'll have a go. Now theoretically, the 10 stop should just clip on, which is a huge bonus given where I'm perched. Okay, so we are at, let's have a look, F14, I'm going to go for 30 seconds. White balance is being changed to 10,000. That actually looks quite warm. Right, let's see what happens with that. I will, once this one's run, as I say, 30 seconds, I'll try it with the white balance set at 10,000 kelvins, 5,850 kelvins, which is basically daylight. I'm only assuming, and I know you shouldn't assume, that it's going to have a cast, a colour cast, the same as the leaf does. We shall see. Right, back in a sec. Well, I tried one without the polariser. The polariser was having a little bit of an effect. As I say, the sun is possibly the right angle. I'm actually quite impressed with the colour reproduction. The lack of a colour cast when using the 10 stop is quite impressive. Quite impressed with that. Now, having said I wasn't going to use the bags, I'll pop them back in there now. As I say, the biggest drawback for me is the lack of a grad filter. Now, I know you can get circular grads. I've never been particularly keen on them because sometimes I want the grad effect to start high up. Sometimes I want it to start low down. If there's a nice dramatic sky and I want to make the most of it, then I want the grad filter to come all the way down. When you have a circular filter on, you can't do that. It is where it is. But there's pros and cons to everything. I quite like that little packet, that little pouch. That's quite handy, that. Now I'm going to pop the leak filter, even putting the adapter on. It could be my cat candidness, but my God, it's a pain in the bum. Filter holder. This is the one that drives me insane. That is irritating. As I say, it has cost me a blowing 10 stop filter before now. Pop in the polariser. I believe the new filter holder system from Lee makes it less of a monkey to put the polariser on, because that is a proper monkey. So let me come back to you once I've set this up, twiddled it to how I want it, see how much of an effect this gives us, and I'll set the white balance because I know the 10 stop filter gives me a colour cast, and then I'll come back to you. Right, I've done exactly the same images. The only thing I didn't do, oh, wind's picking up, I'm keeping on the tripod. The only thing I didn't do was take the polariser off, but I turned it so that it was not polarising. Yes, it's emphasised the fact that the Lee 10 stop has colour cast. Too bothered. Am I impressed with that little K&F setup? Actually, I am. If I hadn't used the Lee filter system, I think I'd be more than happy with that once I've got my head around how to do a grad filter with it. So for the money, I think, memory serves, I think they're about 80 quid. And I think that's a bit of a bargain. I am genuinely impressed with how it performed, particularly given that these are not ideal circumstances. I was kind of expecting all sorts of horrible colour casts and the 10 stops not actually work properly. But no, I'm quite impressed with that, especially given how light. I mean, that weighs like a feather. It's ridiculous. I know I've got a shed load more filters in my bag, but that is as light as a feather, and it's useful. It's got handy things on it. Whereas the Lee filter bag I have to hang over my neck. If it's a really calm day, I can get away with hanging it around the tripod. But that, you probably could. Well, I'd latch it onto my trousers. So far, I'd have to say, actually, that is quite a decent little bit of kit. But yes, it's the K&F filter magnetic, sorry, the K&F magnetic filter system. It's a little, feels a little bit insecure, but that could just be me because I'm not used to it. It probably wouldn't come off in a Gale Force 10, I don't know. But yeah, I think for 80, 90 quid, that's a proper little bit of kit. Right, that's it. I'll put links down below so you can go and have a look at K&F site. As I say, their tripod, the abuse it gets is obscene. I've stripped it down two or three times and cleaned everything. The rubber grips are a little bit loose, but I'd expect that. It is not a 400 quid tripod. It was, I think it's £110 or something. But I do quite like their gear. Yeah. Right, I'll pop up any more images I've got with the comparison with the Lee system, and you can make up your own mind. Thank you very much for watching. See you again.